It's a conservation project.
Unless there's a concerted, focused effort on conservation, then future generations won't get to enjoy it, won't get to see the natural beauty that is here.
One of the interesting parts about the Galapagos, most of the population arrived in the last 20 or 30 years. And as a result, a lot of the tradition, a lot of the culture has been lost.
You're using newspapers and magazines that would get thrown out. You're turning them into something productive and beautiful, and you're helping the women of Ecuador become more independent. It's just a wonderful feeling. If you sit and make a bead, and while you're making the bead, you think, gee, you know, an Ecuadorian woman is gonna make this into a necklace or a bracelet, and this is gonna feed her family. It just gives you such a good feeling of helping.
When she started making the beads, right away she had the opportunity to sell her product to the Lindblad Global Galleries, to boat ships, the Islander and Endeavour in Galapagos. So it was just, okay, I produce and then I sell. Her goal, yes, it will be to teach these for future generations. She had the courage to keep on, and now she's a successful artisan.
Conservation, sustainability, to be creative in this changing world, to figure out ways that we're non-destructive and yet still have a rich life from added in value.
First of all, learning the behavior of these animals so we can somehow predict what they're going to do. Many times when we take a picture of something amazing, like the diving of a blue-footed booby, we will miss it because we see it for the first time. But if we observe, we're listening to the naturalists, we learn about what's going to happen, we can kind of predict and foresee some of the things that might happen and therefore get better pictures.
Can't take a trip like this without learning and being exposed to an awful lot of things that help you be a better human being going forward.
Guests will be able to go beyond the obvious picture, the tourist kind of point of view of taking pictures and sharing with their friends, and go beyond that and be able to use the pictures to send a message of conservation.
Using art and nature together helps people see the details of the land and the animals a little more intimately. For individuals with the Lindblad expedition, to maybe they've never drawn, or they did as a child, or they want to get back to it, and they've spent their whole life doing something else. So for me to be able to sit down with them and get them comfortable with the idea that they can draw, that they can paint.
Now, what I will say is,
they take them home, they talk about their experience. So it's sustainable, it's using resources that would normally not be reused. It's aesthetic, it's beautiful, and it, again, connects us with the aesthetics of where we've been. So coming to this special place and sketching and drawing the plants and animals, I think when we go home with those same drawings, we end up bringing back with us the idea, the memory of how special and rare these islands are. We're adding value with things that don't have value to us initially. It's a creative power, and more people will be doing that with their lives and bringing a sustainability to the world and keeping the aesthetics and the appreciation in place.
Bringing that sustainability and bringing that preservation to life in them, and they really value that.
This is real live today, and it has an impact for my grandkids going forward.
For the very first day.
I think it's a responsibility that we take and should take seriously to try and conserve what we do have in the way of natural resources. To understand that this is a precious commodity that we have, and without it, it won't endure.
I urge everyone to do it, to get involved in it.